to another soccer made in Germany. And now I'm sure that after the German national anthem, the anthem of the United States of America will be sung. Certainly a memorable occasion here. These two fine teams playing each other for the first time. And now that the two national anthems have been sung, that of Germany and that of the United States, we can get on with the game, and the name of the game, of course, is soccer. The New York Cosmos versus FC Cologne. I suppose you could call it soccer made in USA, but the game has a very strong German element, not only because of FC Cologne, but because the new coach of the Cosmos is Hennes Weisweiler from West Germany, who used to coach FC Cologne and has come direct from Cologne to New York. That's the reason for this game, as Cologne in the dark strip, kickoff playing from right to left. The referee, by the way, Mr. Gino DiPolito, assisted by his two linesmen, Howard Krollpfeifer and Felix Fuchsmann. Let me give you the two teams. The Cosmos playing with Hubert Birkenmeier in goal. Hubert Birkenmeier, of course, used to play in West Germany for Freiburg. And then the back four of number two, Andranik Eskandarian, number 25, Jeff Durgan, number five, Carlos Alberto, and number three, Bruce Wilson. In midfield, number seven, Julio Cesar Romero, number six, Franz Beckenbauer, number eight, Vladislav Bogicevic, and number 17, Rick Davis. The two strikers, number nine, the captain, Giorgio Chinaglia, and number 14, Mark Liverick. FC Cologne with Harold Schumacher in goal. And then the back four of number two, Harold Konopka. Number six, Bernd Kullmann, the captain. Number five, Bernd Schuster. And number three, Thomas Kroot. In midfield, number seven, Stefan Engels. Number eight, Herbert Neumann. Number four, Yasuhiko Okudera. The three front runners, number nine, Dieter Müller. Number 10, Tony Woodcock. And number 11, Holger Vilmar. Cologne flew from Germany to New York over the weekend. Some of the players still are suffering a bit from jet lag. There's, of course, a very long flight and a 7-hour time difference. The time here in the stadium just turned 9 p.m. But for most of the Cologne players, it's 4 o'clock in the morning. So that could be a handicap. Plus the fact, of course, that they're playing on AstroTurf, the synthetic turf. And hardly any of the players used to that. As Chinaglia bundled off the ball there by Engels. A section of the crowd, about 25,000 here in the Giant Stadium. I'm sure it would have been a lot more. And up there went Birkenmeier. That's Konopka. Tony Woodcock, can he get to that one? He pulls it back well. It's Alberto. As I was saying, I think a lot more than 25,000 would have come to this game if the weather had been better. It's drizzling here in the stadium, and during the last couple of days there's been torrential rain, which has made the surface of this pitch like a sponge. Nothing at stake, of course, in this game except personal prestige. Oh, what a good effort that was! And Birkenmeier, watch it now, scampering across his goal, and he just passed the post, that one, from Ben Schuster. Is Bogicevic. Stefan Engels back there, and Harald Schumacher skidding on that on the AstroTurf, out of his area. Really went along there as if he were on water skis. So, free kick. Bogicevic getting the ball from Harold Konopka. Cologne team will be flying straight back tomorrow to Germany, because of course they have a league match at the weekend. Eskandarian. Again, the water flying up there from the surface of the pitch. Franz Beckenbauer, there's a rumour of France returning to Germany. Just how true it is, I don't know. I do know that the reigning West German champions Hamburg, present leaders in the Bundesliga, the National League, are very interested in Franz Beckenbauer. There's Beckenbauer on the ball now. One of the all-time greats of soccer, of course. Beautiful player. So skillful on the ball. Harald Konopka with the throw-in. I love that fanfare. Cologne looking dangerous in these early stages. Liverick. Beckenbauer to Alberto. I'm always fascinated by this Cosmos team because in the team this evening, seven different nationalities. Arnold Schumacher having a little trouble with that because of the wet surface. The Cosmos must surely be the most international soccer team in the world. Mark Leverick from the United States. Kinalia. Very powerful player, Giorgio. And the shot over the top. Harald Schumacher saying something to the defenders in front of him there. Thomas Kroth, the number three, the left back. Bernd Kuhlmann and Tony Woodcock. The most expensive player in German soccer at the moment. English international cost Cologne about 2.5 million marks. That's about $1.3 million. Okudera. Round of applause there for Andranik Eskandarian. Franz Beckenbauer. Whistle's gone. Foul by Bogicevic. Konopka with the cross. Linesman had his flag up.
Offside, go on. Indirect free kick, Hardwood.
Wilson. Bruce Wilson from Canada. Carlos Alberto. Neskandarian. Some great names in this Cosmos side. Beckenbauer with the pass to Canalia. And Schumacher. Looked like a handball. Yes, it was. And the Cosmos certainly getting plenty of support, as you can hear in the background there. They're being encouraged, of course, by the cheer girls, which in Germany, unfortunately, we don't have. I'm sure many of the fans would love to have something just as attractive as that. Franz Beckenbauer. Bogicevic. Romero from Paraguay. Giorgio turns it and gets the shot in. Well, and Schumacher. Giorgio Chinaglia. Used to play for Lazio Rome. Has now taken American citizenship. Been with the Cosmos since 1976. Now the captain of the club. And the leading goal scorer, of course. In fact, it was Giorgio Chinaglia who got the Cosmos goal in their last match when they lost against Tulsa by 2-1. There's Yasuhiko Okudera. There's Kandarian. From Iran. Here he is again. Likes to attack down that right flank. Looking for the 1-2. Not working out. Romero tried to go it alone. And Woodcock. Konopka. Cologne actually without three of their regular players. Two fullbacks, Zimmermann and Prestine, and the centre-back, Gerd Strack. Strack and Prestine injured, and so they haven't even travelled from Cologne to New York. They stayed in Germany, and Herbert Zimmermann is obviously upset by the flight, as he's got a little bit of stomach trouble, and so was declared unfit for this evening's match. Pity, actually, because I'm sure the fans here would like to have seen Herbert Zimmermann, West German international, a fine attacking fullback. Thomas Kroth. The Cosmos also without a couple of their regular players, two Dutchmen, Johan Neeskens and Wim Rijksbergen. Also the Portuguese international, Seninho. Woodcock, good tackle, Alberto covering well there, Carlos Alberto. Mark Leverick. Alberto. Bogicevic. Bogicevic and Franz Beckenbauer, the midfield axis, really, in the Cosmos team. Although I think it's a well-known fact that Beckenbauer himself would much prefer to play sweeper. It'll be interesting to see whether, under Hennes Weisweiler, he moves back from midfield into the role he used to play in the West German national team as sweeper. Bogicevic now. Canalia up there, gets a head to it. No trouble for Harold Schumacher. Okudera. Bogicevic covering well, getting there before Vilma. And Beckenbauer with room. Well, that was a bad one. Kroth. Must look gone though. Free kick taken quickly. Canalia and Schumacher. Giorgio Chinaglia. Still a fine player. So too is that man, Carlos Alberto. I love that fanfare. I think he must have heard me. Rogicevic. That was close. Romero was coming in there. And Schumacher. Herbert Neumann. There's talk of Herbert Neumann leaving Cologne and possibly going to Spain. He's certainly not happy with the club at the moment, the ex-international. Rogicevic with a good clearance. Vladislav Bogicevic, ex-Yugoslav international. Kroot. Okudera. He's got Kroot outside him. Yes, there's the pass. Franz Beckenbauer. Almost seems to have a magnet built into his boot, as the ball always seems to go to him. Canalia, can he get to that one? No, he won't. Schumacher's there quicker. Bernd Kullmann. Dieter Müller. That was a good ball. What chance here? And what a save! What a brilliant save by Hubert Birkenmeier. Here's that scene again. Ball pulled back. First time pass and the first time shot. Brilliant shot there by Neumann. And a brilliant save by Birkenmeier. Liverick, Beckenbauer to Canalia. Canalia! Hit it first time on the turn, but no trouble for Tony Schumacher. His real name is Harold, but all the fans call him Tony. Here's the half-time whistle goes here in the Giants Stadium. No score in this friendly match. Cosmos 0, Cologne 0. Cosmos to kick off at the start of the second half, and Cologne have brought on two substitutes. Holger Vilmer, the number 11, has gone off on the left wing, and he's been replaced by number 12, Pierre Littbarski. And in goal, Jürgen Ehrmann has come on in place of Harald Schumacher. Cosmos still with the same 11 players, as I can make out anyway. There's Mark Liverick. Neumann. It'll touch on. Well, that looked like a foul from behind. No, the referee says play on, or does he? No, he's giving a free kick. There's Franz Beckenbauer. Bogicevic and Beckenbauer. Rick Davis. Wasn't on balance when he tried that shot. Woodcock. Schuster. Konopka. He's got Litbarski inside. Birkenmeier. First time. That could have been very dangerous indeed for the Cosmos. Bogicevic, Carlos Alberto, Franz Beckenbauer, all of them over 30, but all of them still great players. So experienced, so skillful. A little misunderstanding there. Dieter Müller now for Cologne. That looked like a foul. The referee allowing play to go on. That's a bit surprising because the ball wasn't played. Bogicevic. Canalia. His shot is blocked. Oh, against the bar! What a tremendous shot there from Giorgio Canalia. Time on the volley, magnificent shot, hits the bar. Oh, and the referee's consulting his linesman now. Is he going to give a goal? He can't. There you can see where the ball bounced way off the goal line. But the referee, I think, is going to give a goal, or the linesman is indicating anyway. Now, this is amazing. Look at Harald Schumacher, rather Jürgen Ehrmann, the substitute goalkeeper. This is crazy. Well, if that was a goal, my grandfather was the Tsar of Russia. I can tell you he certainly wasn't, but the referee has given a goal. Well, I don't think that neither the referee nor the linesman could have been that short-sighted, because as you saw several times on the action replay, the ball rebounded off the crossbar a good meter, at least a meter away from the goal line, in front of the goal line. So certainly no goal. But the referee has decided that it was one. So the Cosmos are leading Cologne by 1-0. I must admit that the shot from Giorgio Canalia was certainly worth a goal. It was a brilliant shot. But it was never across the goal line. So a very bad decision there by Gino DiPolito. And that decision has made it Cosmos 1-0. There's Bernd Kullmann. Jürgen Ehrmann, the substitute goalkeeper. Well, Cologne came here to the Giant Stadium, to New York, fairly confident that they were going to do well. But they're a goal down now. Even if a goal should never have been given. And this is a setback, a real setback for Cologne, because they've been doing so badly in the West German National League recently. There's Ricky Davis. And Mark Leverick trying to pull it back. It's a corner. Mark Leverick. What a chance here.
Shot by Eskandarian. Goal kick, Nestle Cologne.
Andronic Eskandarian. The attacking right back in the Cosmos team. And Bernd Coleman. He's going to push his team forward now in an effort to get the equalizer. Giorgio Canalia. Don't forget, by the way, that you're watching Soccer Made in Germany this evening from the Giant Stadium in New Jersey. The game between the New York Cosmos and FC Cologne. The game was arranged because the ex-Cologne coach, Hannes Weisweiler, has now taken over as the head coach of the Cosmos. Although actually he's not on the on the coach's bench tonight. He's up in the stands with the Cosmos leading officials. This evening the team is still being coached by Giulio Mazzai, who in future will be assisting Hannes Weisweiler. Oh, that was a foul. Herbert Neumann. And he's been shown the yellow card for that by Gino DiPolito. In other words, if he does it again, he'll get his marching orders. So it's a free kick for the Cosmos. I can see Beckenbauer there on the ball. Canalia, Beckenbauer. Under Hannes Weisweiler, of course, the Cosmos hoping to regain the NASL title, the title they lost last season to Vancouver Whitecaps. And actually, FC Cologne at one stage of this season were hoping to win the West German title. They were third in the league, doing very well indeed, just behind Hamburg and Bayern Munich. They've lost their last four games in succession in the Bundesliga. They dropped down to fifth place. They've no chance of winning the league now. In fact, they've only taken 2 points from their last seven games, Cologne. And they were looking for a win here in the Giant Stadium this evening to boost their confidence for the forthcoming league match on Saturday. But the way things look at the moment, they're not going to get it. They're a goal down. A very debatable goal, but still a goal scored by Giorgio Canalia. At least the referee said it was a goal, and he's the man who counts. Knopka. Oh, and coming in there at that left flank was Stefan Engels. Wilson back to Birkenmeier. Hubert Birkenmeier taking his time. Beckenbauer. See if the Cosmos can take advantage of that bad pass. It's a corner. I can tell you, by the way, that on the Soccer Made in Germany, we've got some great things coming up for you, some great matches, including the three European club finals in the UEFA Cup. That is between Frankfurt and Mönchengladbach. In the Cup Winners' Cup competition between Arsenal London and Valencia of Spain. And in the European Champions Cup competition between the holders Nottingham Forest of England and West German champions Hamburg SV. And then later on, the European Nations Championship from Italy, where the eight finalists are, of course, the host nation, Italy, England, Belgium, Spain, Holland, Czechoslovakia, Greece, and West Germany. So really some wonderful soccer in store for you on this show, Soccer Made in Germany. At the moment you're watching the New York Cosmos against FC Cologne. The score, 1-0 for the Cosmos. The goal scored by Giorgio Chinellia after 54 minutes. Schuster, Mark Liverick winning the day there for the Cosmos. Schuster again. Chinellia. Bogicevic. Yes, it's in the net. Romero has made it 2-0. There's no doubt about that one. Bogicevic. Beautiful pass inside. First time shot from Julio Cesar Romero. And that could be that. The first goal may have been very debatable. There was no doubt about this one. Bogicevic. Beautiful little pass inside. First time shot from Romero, the Paraguayan, into the back of the net. 2-0 the score. Romero getting a hug there from Mark Liverick. So Cologne really fighting an uphill battle now. Tony Woodcock.
Corner kick, FC Cologne. The Cosmos goal scored by
Stefan Engels. Engels again with the corner. If they're going to get back into this game, Cologne need a goal quickly. Birkenmeyer, what a fine goalkeeper he is. Pulled off some brilliant save this evening. And Chinellia. Giorgio Chinellia, who's certainly given Schuster a lot of trouble. Schuster actually playing as a centre-back in the absence of Gerd Strack. There's Bernd Kullmann, the sweeper. Originally, it was intended for a... Oh, offside there. For Hannes Weisweiler to stay with Cologne till the end of the season. But he and the club officials had a little difference of opinion. And so he's joined the Cosmos earlier than planned. And I'm sure the New York Cosmos players and officials will be very glad about that fact. Hannes Weisweiler, regarded as one of the most experienced soccer coaches in the world. Romero, as Chinellia, making a lot of room for himself. Schuster unable to follow him. Eskandarian. Beckenbauer. Switching play. Beautiful ball. Bogicevic. I think that one was going if it hadn't been blocked. Jürgen Ehrmann would have known all about that one in the Cologne goal. Another effort from Giorgio Canalia. Bruce Wilson. Oh, Canalia, it must be it. Number three, Giorgio Canalia has made it 3-0. And I would say that's definitely that now. The ball breaking through there to Canalia, not offside. And Giorgio doesn't miss ones like that. Jürgen Ehrmann coming off his line, but no chance. So after 71 minutes, it's now the New York Cosmos 3, FC Cologne 0. And what a turn up for the books this is. I suppose in a way you could excuse the poor performance of the Cologne players by saying that they're not used to the AstroTurf, or maybe they've had an exhausting trip. They're suffering from jet lag, they haven't had time to settle down. And because of the 7-hour time difference as well. But there's no denying the fact that on the night at least, the Cosmos have been the better team. Of course, when you're playing in a different continent, it is very difficult for the opposition. We saw this, that was no trouble from Birkenmeier. But we saw this when the Cosmos played in Germany against Bayern Munich. And were beaten very heavily. But when Bayern came here to the Giant Stadium, they only managed to gain a narrow victory. So there's no doubt that it does make a difference. But still, no excuses for Cologne. They're being beaten by a better team on the night. And that team is the New York Cosmos. Beckenbauer always seems to have so much time, Franz Beckenbauer, the hallmark, of course, of any great player. Never hurried, never rushed. Beckenbauer. Is he going to get one himself? One, two. Franz Beckenbauer, and that wasn't far off target. Hoi! Throw in for Cologne, Thomas Kraut. Little Pierre Littbarski. No trouble at all for Hubert Birkenmeier. The Cosmos team on the night have certainly been far more controlled, far more composed. Played better together. They've not only got the better individuals, but they've look more harmonious. They've played better together as a team. And I'm sure after this match, no matter what the result, there's going to be a lot of questions asked in the Cologne camp. And certainly the new coach of Cologne, Karl-Heinz Hedegott. Can't be envied for his new job. But I can imagine that Hennes Weisweiler up there in the stands is feeling pretty pleased and pretty happy that he's made the decision to come to New York and take over the Cosmos. The Cosmos so far have played five NASL games. They've won three, lost two. As I was saying earlier, lost the last one against Tulsa by 2-1. But they're certainly looking good this evening. Kinalia. Bogicevic. Kinalia. The Cosmos players finding their men so well. As soon as I say that, the ball goes past Romero. Bruce Wilson. Beckenbauer. Perfect pass. Bruce Wilson. Bogicevic. Romero got the second goal. Herbert Neumann, we certainly haven't seen much of him this evening. As I was saying earlier though, he's unhappy with the club, wants to leave. Dieter Müller. Canalia, Giorgio Canalia really has been here, there and everywhere. Caused the Cologne defence so much trouble. Franz Beckenbauer. Jürgen Ehrmann. There's Tony Woodcock. Woodcock actually the only one of the Cologne front runners who seems to have any life in him. Pierre Littbarski gets a corner. Littbarski with the corner. There's Pierre Littbarski again. Oh, that was a bad one. Mark Leverick said, thank you very much. Wilson. There's Leverick. He's offside.
Mark Leverick is offside. Indirect free kick, FC Cologne.
Konopka and Woodcock. Tony Woodcock, English international, will be playing, of course, in those European Championship finals in Italy for England. And in Italy, he might be playing against some of his old teammates. That is, his Cologne teammates, of course. Players like Kullmann and Schuster, and possibly Herbert Zimmermann, who'll be in the West German squad. The fans a little unhappy with these rather time-wasting, or shall we say slowing the game down tactics by the Cosmos. But you can understand them. They've got an important league game coming up. They don't want to overdo things. They've got the game sewn up anyway. They're leading by 3-0. Rick Davis was a bad one from him. Dieter Müller.
Ladies and gentlemen, the attendance at Giant Stadium this evening
Litbarski. Konopka. That's the first halfway decent effort we've seen at the Cosmos goal for a long time. Cologne have seldom threatened in this second half. Woodcock, oh yes, it's there. Cologne have pulled the goal back. Tony Woodcock. It's a pat and a run from Dieter Müller. The ball breaking over to Woodcock, hits it with his left foot on the volley, first time. No chance this time for Hubert Beckenmayer. All the heads going up, but the ball breaking to Tony Woodcock. So it's now the Cosmos 3, FC Cologne 1. Tony Woodcock, Woodcock saying, come on boys, maybe we can still do it, but I don't think so. Romero. I'm making about 7 or 8 minutes left to play. Cologne still 2 goals in arrears. But at least that goal from Tony Woodcock may have lifted their game a little bit, given them a new lease of life. Bogicevic. Eskandarian there complaining that he thought he was fouled. Bogicevic was just behind him. Number 16. That's Angelo Di Bernardo. So it looks as if the Cosmos are going to bring on a sub. Carlos Alberto is going off because he was just going to take that goal kick, but he's now walking off the pitch. And so Angelo Di Bernardo is coming on, number 16, in place of number 5, Carlos Alberto. There's Di Bernardo. And Cologne have also brought on another sub. Dieter Moore, number 13, has come on in place of Stefan Engels, number 7. So Cologne now with 3 subs. They brought on 2 just after half time. Now they brought on another one. But Angelo Di Bernardo is the Cosmos' first substitute. What a beautiful pass that was. Schuster. Oh, a little bit of pushing in the back there by Bruce Wilson against the Yasuhiko Okodera. The free kick already taken. Litbarski. Okodera, a little back heel, but didn't come off. Bruce Wilson. There's Wilson again. Bruce Wilson from Canada, used to be with the Chicago Stings. Joined the Cosmos earlier this year. Romero. And that's the latest substitute in the Cologne team, Didemore, number 13. He's not getting anywhere either. And I'm sure the few Cologne fans who made the trip across the Atlantic to New York will be very disappointed by their team's performance. That could have been 4-1. Cologne hoping for a good performance here this evening. Have been very disappointing. But again, this shouldn't take anything away from the performance of the Cosmos. They've played some fine soccer. They've been more skillful, more controlled. There's been more urgency in their play. And there's no doubt at all they thoroughly deserve their 3-1 lead. Even if the first goal was never a goal. But it goes down in the book as a goal, and that's what counts. Jürgen Ehrmann coming off his line very quickly. Konopka. Tony Woodcock, at least he hasn't stopped trying. The majority of the Cologne players, though, well, they haven't given very much. Dieter Müller. Okudera, he's got Konopka outside him. Harald Konopka. And Birkenmeier. Beckenbauer was back there. Bogicevic. Well, that was a bad one. That was even worse.
Over the goal line. Goal kick.
Cologne now looking very scrappy indeed. In fact, play in general in these closing stages rather scrappy. The Cosmos have a comfortable 3-1 lead. I think they know they're not going to lose it. And Cologne just can't put the effort into trying to get the equalizer at least. Of course, they've got to score twice, but still, apart from one or two players, I think they've already given up. Liverick with the cross. Mick Davis leaving it. Jürgen Ehrmann, no trouble with that one. And Tony Woodcock, Eskandarian, putting the ball out of play. Well, the new Cologne coach, Karl-Heinz Hedegaard, has certainly got a lot of hard work in front of him. Cologne have no chance of winning the Bundesliga. But they're through to the semi-finals of the West German Cup competition. The whistle's gone. I didn't think it was offside, but still, offside. The linesman had his flag up. But unless they can play a lot better than they played this evening, or a lot better than they've been playing of late in the Bundesliga, Cologne have no chance at all of winning the West German Cup. Herbert Neumann. That's it. It's all over here in the Giant Stadium, where the New York Cosmos have very deservedly beaten FC Cologne of West Germany by 3-1. Canalia got the first, very debatable, but there was no doubt about the next two, from Julio Cesar Romero and Giorgio Canalia getting the third. Tony Woodcock pulling one back for Cologne, but it wasn't enough. 3-1 the final score, very deserved. And with that, this is Toby Charles saying goodbye till the next time we meet on Soccer Made in Germany. Made in Germany was provided by the German Educational Television Network and was made possible in part by this station and other public television stations.